If there's anything them fascists are going to go after me for, it's for saying that I'm a white supremacist, because I'm honest. I've been a white supremacist ever since I found out the history of inventions, and it basically is all white. And so ever since then, I realized I believe that the most creative people are white. It don't mean that I don't appreciate the ability of other people to contribute, and it don't mean that I don't think that all white people are, or it doesn't mean I think all white people are smart. I don't feel like I should use an accent for this one. Here's the deal. I am a white supremacist because I believe we should be in charge, and I believe we're the smartest, and I believe we have the most technology, and I believe that we actually understand what's going on. But clearly I'm not a Donald Trump white supremacist, because Donald Trump is a racist person that's an asshole that uses that stuff, but I'm the type of white supremacist that would never, ever, ever, ever be racist to someone, that would never talk down to them, that would think that if you're like Colin Powell, of course I'm gonna listen to you. You know way more than me about a lot of things. Like, you're clearly a very well-educated black man. Like, if there's anything I know, that is that Colin Powell is smarter than a very, very large amount of white people, because Don't Call Me White. That's a song by NOFX. It's like, don't call me white. It represents everything I hate when you, like, lump me in with all these white people. And so, I'm the founder of the white people, I'm the big brain, or we are the big brains, but don't call me white. What I'm trying to say is, when you don't believe that you're a white, like you're white, in fact, because you're more specific, then it means that you treat white people like black people, like Mexican people, like Asian people, like whatever, but it doesn't mean that I don't view everyone through the perspective of culture. Like my whole, the difference between me and Joe Biden, the difference between Donald Trump and me, is that I see everyone through their religion and their philosophy and their culture. Like the reason I can lump Malaysia and Singapore together is because I see your culture. Oh, no, our soup is more spicy. We're not the same people, trust me. And Singapore doesn't taste the same there. Okay, yeah, actually, Malaysia and Singapore are the same, but Singapore's rich. It's kind of like the Indonesians are different because they're Muslims. They're different types of Muslims. But you can still lump in all the Muslims together because they have this thing in common. It's just like evangelical Christians, a lot of people that are like non-denominational or that are Protestant, you can lump together, and then the Catholics you can lump together. But then you can lump them all together, but then you can also, it's like when you're coding and you're branching off, like when you're trying to do a hierarchy. And I understand that in my code I don't really do this very much. But I do understand. I mean, the reason I can code in Scala is because I understand the hierarchy of the data structures. But what I'm trying to say is that when you're classifying people, you can put labels on them that help you understand who they are. And I actually know how to do that. Like, and I understand. I feel like some like specifically gay people get mad at me because they're like, no, he'll label us as gay. He'll think that we have all been hated and that we all have we have all experienced like the way that people are, which is fucking assholes. But also that also means that you might be sensitive to certain, I mean, like it's hard to explain how, like, there's nothing wrong being gay, but there's something wrong with what being gay can do to you sometimes. Oh, but to some people, because like it just, you end up being a victim, and who knows that I've been brainwashed. Yeah, I went to a boarding school with Jesus, and I said Jesus was brainwashed because he went there longer than me, and I feel like I shouldn't have said that, but like it's because they did brainwash us. They like play like tapes in the background, like telling us to chew our food 100 times before we swallow it and stuff like that. It was really weird. But when you get out, you're kind of like brainwashed because you don't know how to function in society for like the first couple months, and then you get back. But I don't know. All I'm trying to say is I'm not a white nationalist. And I believe the reason the United States is so incredible is because we have so many people from different countries. Because I believe that what matters is that you can contribute. And if there's anything I know, is that we've got Indian people that contribute massively to the world through the United States. And we have Chinese people that contribute massively to the world through the United States. And we have Taiwanese people that contribute massively to the world through the United States. And we have Mexicans that contribute massively to the world through the United States, because they come here, they work for us. And that's why, like, when I'm saying, well, why would you put a Venezuelan in charge of me for this research project that's classified, can't talk about it? And then he's kind of like a fucking dick. And like, my thought was that you guys were trying to fail me by putting me with someone that was like specifically trying to not give me data, like go invent math without any data at all. Like, you know, and then if you want to, like, if you veer from his project at all, because it's kind of like doing agile. Like, agile is a way of developing software where you are flexible, where you're like, where the schedule isn't a long-term project. Like, there are different types of project management. There's planning a long-term project. Like, when you're building a plane, you have to have it very long-term. And then there's also agile, but agile is like short-term, but a lot of time agile is for software development, but the plane would also have agile. Like, the software developers for the plane would have agile, because you don't know how far you're gonna get. You don't know how you're gonna have to change things. You don't know how you're gonna have to adjust things, because sometimes you have to ghetto rig the code, especially if you're not the best coder. And so all I'm trying to say is that, I don't know what I was trying to say. I think I'm trying to say that government's not agile, but that's not actually what I was trying to say at all. I really did get distracted. All right, sorry about that. I'm talking about, don't call me white. That's what I'm actually talking about. It's hard to explain how you can be white supremacist without being racist, and you can be white supremacist without thinking white people are supreme. Yeah, that's the bottom line, is like, if there's anything I know, is that the world's not white. And if there's anything I know, is that I'm not supreme everywhere. And if there's anything I know, is that I don't even care. Because I don't even need to be supreme here. And that's why when I say Jesus can be in charge in Jerusalem, it's because I really don't care. And that's reality. And I don't even know if Jesus is going to want to be. Because like, Jesus probably doesn't want to be around them either. But it's kind of crazy how it can hurt Jesus so much that he is a Christian artist that smokes cigarettes. Don't let the Christians see you smoke a cigarette. They're going to hate you. But then he's not a secular artist because he says the word Jesus in his songs. I'm talking about the band Wide Awake. He has a song that's like his That Thing You Do. It's his hit song. And that song says the word Jesus. So he completely ruins himself for everyone that's not Christian. But then when he meets the Christians, he smokes cigarettes, and then they will not accept him. But then I feel like a lot of people accepted him, like people that actually listen to his music, because there's anything I know is that he had a pretty big following in the Austin area until he disappeared.